Hello there. We're the Northeastern University Mars Rover team, and we're thrilled to compete in this year's University Rover Challenge. We're proud to share with you our 2024 Mars Rover, Watney Mark V.
Our 5052 aluminum chassis creates easy access to all inner components, lowering the center of mass and moving the CF differential bar of the rocker bogey suspension to the back increases stability and reduces chassis rocking. Our rover can reliably traverse sloped and rough terrain. The wheels are SLS printed of TPU 90A with nylon CF hubs, resulting in stronger wheels compared to previous years. The curved spokes of the wheels allow for flexibility to drive over rocks and obstacles while supporting our rover for extended travel. To test our design, we are creating a rig to simulate the cyclical forces of continuous usage.
This year, we have completely redesigned our arm with a focus on increased rigidity, precision, and controllability. This was accomplished using our new modular harmonic actuators that are driven by integrated frameless motors with a chain-driven virtual forebar, reducing strain on the stroller of the arm and lowering its center of mass. These changes allow us to hold the position of the lower axis without powering them. Redesign has also greatly improved serviceability and range of motion. For tracking our position, we have implemented new absolute ring encoders generously provided by RLS on the first four joints. These, coupled with our new motor and gearbox setup, have greatly improved our precision when interacting with the Mach lander.
We've redesigned our end effector to use fixed lead screws driven with screw gears. This allows us to minimize its footprint while keeping the characteristics of a parallel gripper that we've found successful. To tackle the new soil sampling challenge, we've added a drilling attachment to the arm. An auger is extended into the soil and retracted into a holding tube using a passive spring-loaded system.
To improve safety standards and accommodate our arm changes, the rover's electrical system has undergone a significant redesign. We've selected new 48-volt batteries to match the higher voltage requirements of the arm's in-runner motors. To supply lower voltages to the rest of the system, we feed the battery output through a 48-to-15-volt regulator into our custom power distribution PCB. This serves as a central power and communication hub for the rover, simplifying cable routing. To protect our electrical system, we've performed a comprehensive current analysis of our rover's major components and integrated blade fuses based on our calculated values. This will prevent overcurrent incidents from burning out components or damaging our batteries. A locking adapter has also been designed for our new batteries, allowing for a simple and safe battery exchange.
For the 2024 competition, we shifted from our previous linear layout to a carousel structure for our life detection module. This improves precision in sample delivery and creates a more space-efficient system. A claw on the rover arm lifts soil into the carousel through a funnel, while a peristaltic pump simultaneously releases water. The resulting soil water slurry undergoes two colorimetric tests for glucose and protein, which are easily readable through onboard cameras, and analysis within our custom UV-visible spectrophotometer for DNA and chlorophyll detection.
Our rover is equipped with both the 2.4 GHz radio and new 900 MHz radio system. For the extreme delivery and autonomous missions, our 900 MHz radio provides strong non-line-of-sight performance and over 1.25 kilometers of range while supporting 8 camera streams. Otherwise, our 2.4 GHz radio saves weight and increases our bandwidth to 25 megabits per second. This year, our team migrated to ROS2 Humboldt, leveraging its QoS features for faster recovery from link failures. The rover features 14 cameras mounted on the chassis, arm, and life detection systems, including a 360-degree camera for panoramic captures. Our custom RTSP-based camera streaming server keeps latency below 200 milliseconds and can adjust each camera's resolution up to 4K or down to 144p. Our new control UI puts camera stream sensor readouts and improved mapping functionality onto separate monitors for chassis and arm operation. We've also added a touchscreen interface to our rover, reducing our typical setup time to under 2 minutes. We use 3 controllers to operate our arm. A puppet controller facilitates broad movements such as lifting objects and collecting soil samples, while a gamepad provides precise Cartesian control backed by an inverse kinematic solver.
When operating autonomously, the rover fuses odometry from dual 10Hz RTK GPS modules, a Z2i stereoscopic camera, and a 9-axis IMU. State estimation is accomplished by an extended camera filter to estimate the rover's position and navigate between GNSS points with sub-centimeter and sub-degree accuracy. New this year is our custom particle filter implementation, increasing accuracy during searching, and our event-driven state machine, improving our system's robustness. In addition to our RUCA detection, we've developed a transfer learning YOLO model for the water bottle and a semantic segmentation model to find the mallet.
NU Rover is once again collaborating with Northeastern's UAV Club to bring back an aerial component to the challenge. We've iterated on last year's drone to navigate to the last recorded location of the rover in case of communication loss, as well as to act as a scout in the extreme delivery mission. Our second iteration will see an increased propeller size to hold a larger payload and achieve a higher motor efficiency.
Our new chassis, arm, electrical system, and communication system have been extensively tested, including at the Winter Canadian International Rover Challenge. From now until June, we will focus on enhancing our control capabilities and preparing for URC through mock competition runs and operator practice sessions. We are confident that we will bring a consistent, robust, and effective rover to URC.
See you in Utah!